My name is David Carnovale, and I'm a reproductive endocrinologist and infertility specialist. I'm also the medical director of Community Reproductive Endocrinology, the fertility practice here at Community Health System. Reproductive endocrinology is a subspecialty of OBGYN. And as a reproductive endocrinologist, we first train as OBGYNs, and then we do additional training to become a reproductive endocrinologist. Many of the women that come to a reproductive endocrinologist are dealing with issues of infertility, but we also deal with things such as endometriosis, polycystic ovarian syndrome, problems with women who get pregnant but lose those pregnancies, and women who have problems with issues related to the structure of their reproductive system. So we actually do a fair amount of surgery in this field. One of the things that I utilize in my work is something called a KTP laser. And this laser is very specialized for the treatment of endometriosis. It allows us to treat in areas that many times are inaccessible with other modalities. One of the most powerful techniques that we have in infertility treatment is in vitro fertilization. And this is commonly known as the test tube baby. And this technique allows us to take a woman's eggs and combine it with her husband's sperm in the laboratory, and then take those embryos that are generated and place them back up into a woman's uterus. Unfortunately, a lot of people think that this is something that's going to guarantee that they have multiple births, and in most cases, that's not true. We can actually reduce the number of embryos that we put back into a woman's uterus. The actual procedure itself is done in the laboratory. We take the embryos in a catheter, and we take that catheter, and we can place it up inside of the woman's uterus and release the embryos where we want them to be. So that gives us a lot of control over what happens with that process. So here we see a human egg being held in place and the injection pipette bringing the sperm directly through the membrane called the zona pellucida, and it's depositing the sperm inside here. So this actually bypasses the process where millions of sperm would be on the outside of the egg trying to penetrate inside. So for men who have a low sperm count, this allows them to have a genetic child, whereas in the past they would have had to resort to donor sperm. So this is a very important and powerful technique that we've had now for about 15 years. One of the other things that's nice about this program is that I get the opportunity to work with Dr. Jeffrey Bolt. And Dr. Bolt is actually one of the leading embryologists in the country, the people who actually do the work in the laboratory that allows us to do the in vitro fertilization process. Dr. Bolt has also been recognized as one of the leaders in egg freezing technology. And this is something that is only provided at a few centers around the United States. It's so unique, in fact, that we've been contacted by a medical broker who has women in Japan interested in coming to Indianapolis to have this technology used on them. And this would allow career women and other women who maybe are facing chemotherapy or radiation therapy for cancer to preserve their eggs for later use in life. One of the things that our practice strives for is to reduce the stress and anxiety that couples dealing with infertility experience. And we want to be as user-friendly as possible. We want to be sure that everyone in our office is familiar with all the issues that these patients are facing. And everyone on my team shares that philosophy. And this allows us to be sure that all patients are treated with the utmost respect and dignity throughout this process. We also have financial counselors who can help patients with the ins and outs of infertility coverage, which can be a real challenge for patients to negotiate without guidance. One of the things that we also provide to patients who come to our office is financial counseling, because the insurance world with infertility is very difficult to understand and presents a number of challenges. And we want to help patients to be sure that they're making decisions that are based upon sound information, so they know what is actually covered and what is not covered. Many patients and doctors are under the misperception that infertility is never covered. And what we find is that many insurance companies will cover the testing and initial evaluation for infertility. And when it comes to treatment, sometimes they'll even cover that. But in a lot of cases, the treatment itself is not covered. The process for a referral to our practice is fairly simple. A phone call to our front desk and we'll take care of the rest. Our goal is to provide both the physicians referring to our practice and patients an exceptional experience. We don't want them to hassle. We'll take care of obtaining records. We'll make sure that everybody is aware of when they need to be here and where we're located. Myself and my office are available to patients pretty much 24/7, 7 days a week. And that's one of the things in fertility medicine we have to be, because we never know when a woman is ovulating and may need an insemination. So many times we'll be here on the weekends as well. Our regular office hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 5 p.m. We also have a website which has a great deal of patient information, and it's a great resource for people looking for more details on what we provide. And that's communityfertility.com.